The aftermath of World War II produced a global struggle in which superpowers fought to control areas of strategic significance. The end of Britain's dominance over the Persian Gulf left a power void in one of the most valuable regions on Earth. This significance stems from the abundance of oil and the Middle East's position as an international crossroads. These factors forced the United States to adopt a new foreign policy focused on cementing regional supremacy. Achieving this supremacy required the U.S. to utilize three primary tactics. First is establishing sound relations with regional leaders. U.S. interests could be secured by aligning with a pre-existing government and then offering them security or aid. The United States' strategic alliance with Saudi Arabia and Israel are the result of lasting relations created almost 70 years prior. If a government did not see an opportunity for a mutually beneficial relationship, the U.S. would empower a regime that did, and as a result, the CIA orchestrated a variety of military coups. These maneuvers produced favorable agreements with the region's top oil producers and a strategic relationship with Israel. Next, the United States arranged large-scale aid programs. Economic aid strengthened the economies of countries susceptible to communism, while also enabling more developed states to continue growing. The U.S. also supplied billions in military aid through grants and arms sales. This allowed countries to defend themselves and U.S. interests without U.S. combat involvement. Between 1950 and 1970, Iran and Saudi Arabia received the majority of aid, before U.S. policy shifted to support Israel and Egypt. Israel's importance to the United States' grand strategy is shown in the vast quantities of resources they receive, thus ensuring both their security and sovereignty. The United States' final means of maintaining its position as a regional hegemon is through direct military intervention. This strategy is a last resort response if U.S. allies or interests face an overwhelming threat. Saddam Hussein's 1990 invasion of Kuwait was exactly that, as Iraqi forces conquered the United States' oil-rich ally. Once evident that no amount of diplomacy or aid would resolve the issue, the U.S. led a coalition force to liberate Kuwait. The 1991 Gulf War was a key test of American supremacy against a powerful regional military. The coalition's advanced technology and training dealt devastating casualties to Iraqi forces, as U.S. aircraft crippled Saddam's army before the coalition ground assault rolled all remaining opposition. It took just 44 days for the United States' decisive victory, solidifying their status and crushing all remaining doubt. While military intervention has developed in recent years, shifting focus from boots on the ground to death from above, the objective of regional security has remained unchanged. Similarly, just because the United States no longer focuses on containing Soviet influence or sustaining a close alliance with Iran, does not mean these strategies have been replaced. They have simply evolved with time and the presence of new threats such as terrorism. Government relations will continue to be the cornerstone of foreign policy, while international aid and military might ensure the United States retains its title of top superpower.